Hello everyone, today we're going to see how to create a full screen video in the background using HTML and CSS. There are three parts to this video. The first one is the basic heading with some text and the video background. The second one is almost similar to the first one, except that we manually play and pause the video via JavaScript. Also, they are responsive. So let me resize it to a mobile screen view. You can notice the text are smaller in the mobile screen view, and in the second video the description text comes down to the bottom in the mobile screen view. Also, there are a few tricks that I want to discuss in the full screen video background in the second video. Now for the third one, it's a full screen YouTube video in the background along with the same description text. Alright, let's start coding. I've already created index.html and style.css, and I'm going to use the live preview option to see the output as we code. I'll start with the usual HTML head and body tags. I'll give a link to the style.css. And I'm going to also include all the meta cache sets. And also viewport for the responsive design. Okay, let's start with defining the header tag. I'm going to give a div container called video container for the video and include the video in it. As you can see, the video is way more expanded than I could scroll it horizontally and vertically. So let's give it a width and height temporarily, and I'm going to set it to autoplay. This would automatically play the video when the page is loaded. But when I open up, it doesn't automatically play the video. But when I open it in Internet Explorer, it automatically plays the video as it should. This is because Google Chrome doesn't let you autoplay the videos if your video is not set to mute. So let's go ahead and set it to mute using muted attribute. Okay, now the video is automatically played when the page is loaded. Also, we need to loop this video, so let's specify that as well. Now I'll remove the basic width and height and move to style.css. I'll start with setting up the basic margin and padding for the body. Okay, now let's go ahead and create the full screen video in the background. Let's mention the video under the video container, set its position to fix, right 0, bottom 0. Let's specify the min width as 100 viewport width and min height as 100 viewport height. Still, the video seems to be so much stretched out. So let's go ahead and give it a height of 100 viewport height. Now it looks like a full screen video background. But in the desktop view, it doesn't cover the entire space. It's because in desktop, the width is bigger than the height. So let's go ahead and create media queries for the desktop view. And in here, we'll mention the width as 100 viewport width and the height as auto. So now it looks like a full screen video background. Alright, now let's text the rest of the header, the text and the buttons. Let's go ahead in the index.html and create a class called textContainer for the text content. I'm going to create another div container called content. Give the heading and some dummy text as description. This doesn't appear because it appears behind the video background. We're going to fix that right now. We can fix that easily using a z-index property. We'll set the z-index property as 1 for the video container, and we'll set the z-index as 2 for the text container. Now this doesn't work until you set the position as fixed or absolute. Great, now the text appears. Alright, now let's set the color to white. Now we are going to create a full screen overlay for this video background. Let's start from the top left corner and cover the entire size and specify a background color. Now there is a transparent overlay with a full screen video background. Okay, now let's go ahead and position the text content. We have to position it center vertically and horizontally. Let's give the text align as center to position it horizontally center, some padding, and also mention the vertical align as middle, but this doesn't work for a non-table element. So let's set the parent element text container to display table. And we'll mention the content as display table cell, and now it is vertically center too. Now let's change the font. First, let's add some Google fonts. I'm going to set the font family for the complete web page. Also, I'll mention the overflow excess hidden to remove the horizontal scroll. I'm going to mention a cursor font for the header. And also give it some letter spacing. In the bigger screen, it looks much smaller. So let's specify a bigger font size under the media queries for the desktop screen. Okay, now it looks good. Now let's style the button. Let's go back to index.html and I'm going to give a button as shop now. I'm using hbutton here as a class, meaning header button. Let's go ahead and style that. Go to CSS file. Open up the hbutton. Give it a background color as white. Give it a font size, font weight as bold, some padding. Also, let's change the border width to 0. Also, let's set the cursor to pointer so that when we hover over it turns to a hand symbol. Now let's add some user interaction when the user clicks on the button. Using active pseudo class, we'll reduce the font size. Alright, now for the bigger screen, we'll enlarge the font size. Okay, it looks much bigger in the desktop screen. Alright, now that concludes our first part of the full screen video background. Let's move on to the next one. Here, the user can control the pause and play of the video. Here, I have copied the same code that we have used before. The previous video is not present in this folder, so it appears pink. So first, I'm going to change this text container to a simple text content. It's not visible because we have made the color as white in our CSS file. So first, I'll change the source name for the video. There, our video appears as a full screen background. Now let's go ahead and remove all the styles that we have created for the text content in the header. Now the video appears fine in the desktop screen, but in the mobile screen, the video is cropped and the center of the nebula is not visible. For this, I'm going to shift it a little bit to the right by setting the right as minus 300 pixels. And now the center of the nebula is visible in the mobile screen. But in the desktop screen, it is shifted to the right. So let's fix that by setting the right to 0 under the media queries for the desktop background. That's a small trick that you can use to position the video in the mobile screens. Now let's go ahead and style the text content to the right. In mobile, it appears at the bottom. So I'll say the position is absolute, bottom as 15 pixel, some padding, and also text align as justified. I'm also going to give a small font size for the paragraph in the mobile view. In the desktop view, I'm going to position it to the right corner. It occupies the entire space. So let's specify it a width. Well, not 30 pixels, it's 30%. Great. Now I'm also going to give a bigger font size for the desktop view. Okay, looking good. Now let's go ahead and design the play button. Let's go to index.html and give a link to the font awesome for the play button. We'll place the font awesome icons inside the header using FA play circle class. Now let's go ahead and style it. We'll make the position absolute. We'll give white color for this. Transparent white. There's a small icon there. Let's position it in the center. Also, we'll give the z-index as 3. Now, if I increase the font size, it doesn't affect the font awesome icons. Let's go ahead and check why it is. Let's go to the console. Track the font awesome icon. And if we see here, the font size is inherit. It is inherited from the parent icon. To fix this, we can enclose the font awesome icon inside a paragraph tag, and we can set the font size to the paragraph tag. Now the size is bigger. I'll set it to 48 pixels and we'll set the cursor to pointer. Now I'm going to create a JavaScript file to manipulate the play and pause of the video background. I'm going to get the ID for the play icon and also the video using document.getElementById followed by the ID name. I'm going to define a function called toggle_pause_play. Inside that, I'm going to check if the video is paused. If yes, it will play the video and the play icon should disappear. Or else, I'll pause the video and set the opacity as 1 for the play icon, so it will be visible back again. Now let's add the click event to both the video and the play icon so that it will toggle play and pause whether I click the video or the play icon. Now if I hit play, it plays. When I click on the background, it pauses. It just toggles play and pause when I click over the video background. Alright, great. Now for the third one, the full screen YouTube video as a background. I'm going to copy the index.html and style.css into a separate folder. I'm going to set the heading as Game of Thrones and also remove the play icon and all the style.css associated with it. Now let's go to YouTube and select a YouTube video. I'll select Game of Thrones trailer. Click on the share button down the video. Click on the embed and copy the code to your right. Now paste it instead of the video here. Let's go and check it. There, the YouTube video is displayed. I'm going to remove the predefined width and height and change all the video to iframe in the CSS file. Now there it is, the YouTube video in the background. But the controls, the heading, and also when I pause the video, the related videos are appearing at the bottom, which I don't want. You can easily customize this by giving a question mark at the end of the link followed by controls equal to 0, meaning false. Now the controllers are gone. Now let's try to remove the heading by mentioning show info is equal to 0. Now the heading is removed. But when I pause, the related videos are appearing. To disable this, we can mention rel is equal to 0. That turns off the related videos. Now the related videos doesn't appear. Also, there is this YouTube branding information on the right bottom of the screen. You can't actually get rid of this completely, but you can set the modest branding equal to 1 and controls equal to 1 so that this YouTube would come as a text under your controls. And if you turn off the controller, this modest branding do not work. This is because YouTube have removed the ability to completely remove a YouTube link from an embedded YouTube video. So that's it, that's the end of the full screen video in background using HTML and CSS tutorial. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it, share your feedbacks in the comments down below, and subscribe to CodeSpot for more such videos. Thanks for watching.